he used a lot of styles. I would say overall there's a kind of gentleness and a kind of humor, and also a range of emotions, certainly a lot of serious emotions too, but it's hard to pin down a specific style. I mean, I could talk about a couple of pieces. When I was first here, I was programming concerts and looking for Manitoba music to put on the radio, and I found a piece of his called Eidolons, which is an orchestra piece, 12 variations on a theme, and I was really taken by that piece. There's a lot of really interesting contrast of emotion. It's an orchestra piece, but it starts with piano and timpani, and then there's, you know, celeste solo and all kinds of some unexpected things, quite a variety. But I would find it hard to classify. I suppose there's parts that remind me a bit of, you know, Stravinsky, parts that remind me a bit of Lutoslavsky and various composers. It would be very hard to specify, but it's really his own style.
The composer's wife sees common characteristics running throughout Turner's work, no matter what the style.
Well, I think two things. One is the sweep of his form. He's able to make sense of what he is writing. And the other thing that is immediately recognizable is his brilliant use of orchestration and his orchestration is like no other, and it doesn't matter whether it's the more accessible children's overture and opening night overture, or say Shades of Autumn, for instance, which is one of the more challenging and more dissonant works. That element comes through, that ability to use instruments in a really quite original way, I think.
Turner's never believed in writing for himself or for posterity. He always said he needed a date and a performance in mind to inspire him. He's a composer with a strong sense of place. On more than one occasion, he's managed to reflect his prairie environment in his music.